Good morning, students. Today I am going to complete your chapter, Discovering Tuck. The saga continues, page number 27, the second last paragraph. Back in the trailer, a technician pulled up astonishing images of Tuck on the computer screen. A gray head looked shaped from a scattering of pixels, and the technician spun and titled it in every direction. Neck vertebrae appeared as clearly as in an anatomy class. Other images revealed a hand, several views of a ribcage and a transection of the skull. But for now, the pressure was off. Sitting back in his chair, Zahi Hawass smiled, visibly revealed that nothing had gone seriously wrong. "I did not sleep last night. For a second," he said, "I was so worried, but now I think I will go and sleep." Page number 28, last paragraph. By the time we left the trailer, descending metal stairs to the sandy ground, the wind had stopped. The winter air lay cold and still, like death itself. In this valley of the departed, just above the entrance to Tuck's tomb, stood Orion, the constellations that the ancient Egyptians knew as the soul of Osiris, the god of entire life, a god after life, watching over the boy king. This is the source taken from the National Geography volume 207, number 6. Now I am going to explain you this last two paragraphs. There are some difficult words here. Stood Orion, the constellations that ancient Egypt knew as the soul of Osiris, the god of the after death, watching over the boy king. Astonishing, that means amazing. Pixels, a pixel is a single point in a graphic image. Spun, to turn around. Spin, fast, spun. Vertebrae, a series of small bones, which forms a backbone. Explanation now. In the trailer, the technicians showed a beautiful image of the Tuck on the computer screen when they started the CT scan. He showed the grey head, which was scattered in pixels. The head was scattered due to the different images of pixels in the scan. He spun it, and again they spin the instrument around. Next, the vertebral hand, rib cage and transections of his skull were shown. First the head was shown, then now it was spinned again, and now the vertebral hand, rib cage and transection of his skull were shown. Whose skull? Whose images were shown here? That's the Egyptian pharaoh, the last Egyptian young king. Skull was being shown here. As the work was done, the pressure was finally off from the shoulders of Zahi Hawass, the person who was just doing the CT scan, who was in very full of tension during the last night when he started the CT scan process. There were lots of trouble during the process, but when they completed it, he took a deep breath that the process finally has been completed to take the scan of the Tuck's body, the mummy. While sitting in the chair, he smiled and said that he was revealed that nothing went wrong. He was very much intense, that as the wind blew very high, there was sand in the fan. They bought another two fans to start the process of scanning. Now after completing it, he revealed that there was no such problem went wrong during the process of the scanning here. And what he said again, he had not slept the previous night, and as the work was done, he would go and sleep now. Now he will go and sleep a relaxation sleep after the work has been completed totally. But the time they left the trailer, the wind had stopped and the winter air was like death itself. Again, when the process stopped, everything stopped. The wind blowing was also been stopped, as if there is a death itself again. It looked everything still there. Just above the tomb, the Orion constellations shone in the night sky, watching over the boy king. It was just as if they were just looking upon the person who was just been scanned here. I have said in the meaning that what is stood Orion, that an Egyptian, ancient Egyptians knew as the soul of the Osiris, the god of the afterlife, watching over the boy king, as if there was someone who was watching the process what we are doing with the thumb, with the mummy here. As they all lifted the mummy from the tomb after so many years, there was someone who was looking upon all the activities what they were doing. As the activity has been completed, as they kept the Tut's body again in a peace way in his tomb back, then everything stopped, came to the same silent process, as if there was someone who was looking upon him from up in the sky, watching over the boy king. But until the end, there was not any clear idea about how that the king has died, what is the mystery about his death that is unrevealed till now. Okay, now complete your textbook question answers, and I hope you have got the idea about what the chapter just wants to reveal here. Okay. Thank you. Complete your question answers. If you have any doubts, you can contact me.